Hey everyone, it's Greg, and today I'm going to cover the biggest number one mistake that I see on new websites. So if you're putting together a new website, stick around for this video because it will help you a lot. So the biggest mistake is using blurry or overly stock photos. When people go to your website, they're relying a lot on what the photos look like, not as much as what it says. So make sure that your website looks the part. So I'm going to show you what I mean here. I'm going to minimize this, get right into the computer. So this is just a template from Wix. So you can easily swap this out. This will make for a good example. So with this background image here, I'm going to change the background image to something that I just downloaded off of Google. So this photo right here is actually this one right here. And as you can see, the pixel size is 582 by 424 pixels. So that is a pretty small image. It's a small file size, so it'll do well on a website. It'll load quickly, but it's a small photo, so it's going to be blurry. And that's why I'm using this example, because most people will have images like this where they look good, but then once you put it on a website and it gets a little bit bigger, it's not as good. So let's change the background to that. See, Wix already knows that this is not a big photo, so they're trying to tile it so it keeps the resolution, but we don't want that. It doesn't look as good. So what I'm going to do is show you the real life scale to fill. So this is what you will be seeing on websites. Now, obviously the text in the background, we would change to a different color so you could read it. But just get an idea here that this is what I'm talking about. So this is a photo that probably looks good to a lot of people, but it's blurry. The background isn't fully crisp. So even when you compare it to something like this, this is full definition. And when you come up here, it's a little bit blurry. So you don't want any blurry photos on your website anywhere, especially not the homepage. So I do want to show you the difference. So if we come back to editor, and if we change this to a good photo, then I'll show you the difference. And if you don't have any high quality photos yourself of your business or whatever you're doing, you can come right to on Wix. There's free from Wix and you can choose from thousands of photos. So if we just type in mountain, I'm going to try to get a similar photo here. And this actually looks pretty cool. So this is a bridge. So all of these photos are great for websites because they are 5,472 by over 3,000 pixels. So it is a very high quality photo. But the file sizes on these are not that big, which is great. And I'm going to talk about that in about 30 seconds here. But let's just choose this photo just so I can show you the real difference of what it looks like. So that looks good. And then let's preview that. So this compared to that hiker before, you can tell the difference in the website. This looks much more professional. Everything is super HD and it looks very clear. So it says a lot about your website before you even say anything. So as I say, a photo says 1,000 words and you definitely want your homepage and all the photos on your website to be clear. So what if you have high quality photos that you want to use on your own website? Well, there's one thing I recommend you do. So you don't want to have big file sizes. You want to have high quality photos, but not big file sizes. So typically I'm dealing with photos that are 10 to 20 megabytes, which is a really big photo size. So like this one, for example, was like 500 kilobytes, which is like half of 1 megabyte. So if you have a big photo, all you have to do is come to compressor.io and just upload your big photo here. You just hit try it and then you can upload your big photo. It's completely free as well. And it compresses it with their compressor to make it, this is before and after. So this left side is before the full size photo. And then the right side over here is the after photo. So all you can see is the difference is 700 kilobytes to 250 kilobytes. So typically I'm uploading photos over 10 megabytes and they're coming out of this compressor under 1 megabyte. And it looks exactly the same. And then I'll upload that smaller one, the compressed one, to Wix, and then I will have high quality, but it will load the website really quickly because they're small file sizes. So I hope that helps you guys. That's Compressor right there. If you have any questions, definitely feel free to let me know. Also, if you want to use Wix to build your website, I put my referral link down in the description so you can use that. It's all the same pricing for you and everything, but it helps me out. So making all these YouTube videos for free, I don't really get paid for that. So if you end up keeping your Wix website down the road and you had signed up with my referral link, then I get a small commission. And that's only if you keep it down the road. So if you do want to use that, I really appreciate it. If not, I totally understand. And the second thing is if you need a walkthrough of how to use Wix, like a full tutorial of putting together your template like this here, I've got another YouTube video and I'll link to that in the description as well. It's like a 50-minute video showing you how all these components come together, good tips and tricks, and just general good practices to putting together your Wix website and using a template, literally going from choosing your template all the way to publishing the site. So if you have any questions, let me know. If you have any specific videos you want me to make, also let me know in the comments. Otherwise, if you like this video, give me a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.